I want to talk a little bit about a statement that was made. Donald Trump and Ben Carson running for president as Republicans. They're threatening to boycott the MSNBC debate because they don't like the format. And then this coupled with the governor's news that he only raised about $1 million compared to, you know, Ben Carson raised $20 million. Something's going on out there. So I'm joined by Matt Rooney. Matt is a lawyer. He is a political expert. He's been doing this for a while. Matt, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. How are you?
Good morning, Bill. Doing great.
So what do you think of this? What do you make of this, Matt? Two questions to you. First of all, the governor raising only $1.2 million. I think it was $1.2 million. I'm looking for the article now. But the question is, how is it possible that Governor Christie, who was literally heralded as the savior of the party going back to 2012, is at $1 million and Ben Carson raised $20 million? What is going on in the Republican Party?
Yeah, listen, you're asking a question that a lot of the political consultants have been asking themselves in the mirror probably every day over the last few months. It's a strange cycle, and it's strange because experience and the other things that usually benefit someone like a governor, like Governor Christie, are actually not only just not helping Bill, they're also a hindrance because people want a different face. They want something new, which is why Trump and Carson are doing so well. One of the things Chris Christie thought could help him and maybe allow him to hang in a little later was his RGA network. Everybody knows that he went around the country for the Republican Governors Association in the past cycle, raised a lot of money, helped a lot of candidates. He thought he'd be able to cash in. He did initially, but at the end of the day, people want to value how they spend their money based on whether they think it's an investment that's going to return.
Right.
He's not. He's not moving up in the polls. So at some point, these big donors need to cut bait and invest their money in somebody who they think has a chance to win, and they're starting to lose faith in the governor.
Well, is this the problem because they have nowhere to go because Donald Trump isn't taking anybody's money? I mean, Trump is saying, hey, I've got the money. I don't need your money. I'm not going to be beholden to anybody, except I think you got to pay $25 for the hats.
That's right.
Right.
That's right, which is a cheap date in politics, Bill. We both know that.
I haven't bought my hat yet, but I you know, I like it. Looks a little big. It looks like it might be a little bit awkward.
Christmas is still coming up, Bill.
That's true.
So you're going to get your hat. But I think you're absolutely right. I think the donors don't have a place to go. They don't trust Trump. They maybe don't think Ben Carson has enough experience. He might be a little green as a presidential candidate.
Do you, Matt? Hey, listen. Do you? Because I've had this discussion with political friends round and round for the last couple months. I think you've got to do something of major accomplishment, you know, leading people before you run for president. And Trump has done that in the private sector. But Carson, I like him, but I don't know. He's a doctor.
Yeah, listen, it's a completely valid concern. And we've heard him speak on various topics, including gun control, where he's given answers that don't quite seem like the doctor has read up and done his homework. And I couldn't blame him because it takes a lot of time to get up to speed in the public sphere in the public sector and learn everything you need to know and be able to regurgitate it articulately. It's a skill, and it's a learned skill. But look, nobody can doubt the guy's intelligent.
Yeah.
The guy's a pediatric brain surgeon. By the same token, I think you're right. I think that if Republicans want to win and then have a successful governing tenure with a president, they have to think about somebody who's actually been to the big game.
All right, Matt, real quick, I've got about 20 seconds. I've made two predictions this morning on Twitter. The first is that Vice President Biden does not run for president. And the second is the Mets beat the Cubs 7-2. What do you think on both?
Oh, geez. I don't know what's less likely, having Joe Biden in the White House or having a Mets World Series. I mean, I'm a Phillies fan, so I can never throw in my bet for the Mets. I don't care how well they're doing, so I'm just going to leave that there.
Okay.
As far as Joe Biden, I definitely think that Hillary Clinton having a stronger debate performance, and by that I mean she got all her buddies in the media to say she did a good job.
Right.
That doesn't make Joe Biden getting in more likely. But listen, the Obama Justice Department seems hot for the trot to indict this person.
Yeah.
They want to indict Hillary Clinton. So I don't think they're going through all that trouble for nothing. I would still bet on Joe Biden getting in the near future.
All right. We'll have that conversation next week, I'm sure. Matt Rooney, have a great weekend. Thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5. We'll be talking soon.